If you want to know what you spend every month on your EV, if you want to know all of your trips, how far did you go, what was your average consumption, if you want to know all of your charging sessions, how many kilowatt hours did you charge, what is your AC to DC ratio, and you don't want to write all of this down yourself, then Tronity is exactly what you need. Tronity connects to your car, a lot of brands are supported, and in the app or in a browser you can see all of this data. You can also have 100% tax-compliant driver's logbook. My viewers get 25% off if they use the link in the description below. Good morning, everyone. Today it's time to do a Tesla battle. This is the Tesla Model Y rear-wheel drive, and this is a Tesla Model Y all-wheel drive, not performance. And today we're charging here the supercharger to 80% and then do a little comparison drive. We drive on the highway, drive 130, come back here. The two cars are exactly the same, so they have 19-inch winter tires on, of course heat pump and everything. The only difference that I see is that Matthias on his Model Y doesn't have the things on because he doesn't like them. He doesn't like the look, and this Model Y has them on. That's the only difference. And this is a press car from Tesla. I'm not gonna do something with it. All the wheels are scratched. And I only also noticed that the winter tires haven't been balanced. Above 135, the whole car vibrates and shakes like crazy. But I'm happy I got a car, so it's fine. So Matthias is coming. And then we drive a bit. On our way, Matthias in his Model Y all-wheel drive is in front of me. We're driving around 130. Right now we're in 120 zones. We of course drive too fast. No. And we reset our trip, drove 18 kilometers so far, and both charged to 80%. We have the same setting for our climate, 20.5 degrees in auto, even though it's way too hot for him. He's a cool guy. He likes it cool, but it's fine. And soon, in 10 kilometers or so, I'm gonna pass him, then I'm in front for a while, and then we do the same thing in return. Reverse. We just turned around, Matthias passed me again, so I passed him before on half of the way. He passed me now, he's in front of me, we're driving for 30 kilometers and then I'm gonna pass him again. And problem, we have to go to a different charger, not to Tesla charger, because I have a press car and I'm locked into this car with the Tesla press account, and for whatever reason I cannot see my charging history. So when we charge, I cannot see how many kilowatt hours we charged. I can only see what the car shows me inside, and that's not very accurate. So we will go to EMBV charger and charge there, so we can see the exact amount of kilowatt hours that we have to charge back to the 80%. But it's time to look at our data. My car is at 64% state of charge. Matthias' car is at?
No, 62.
62? Uh-huh. Yeah. 2% less. And my car has an average consumption of 179, and Matthias' car has?
192.
Ooh, that's a lot.
No.
Can this only be the rims, this new rims? I doubt that. But rear wheel drive, it should be a bit better. That is interesting. We're gonna drive on nicely. It's a lot of highways for another 30 kilometers, but then we have to do a big country road to the other charger. Rear wheel drive arrived with 47%, average consumption 184 watt hours per kilometer. No? 43% and 197 watt hours per kilometer. We plugged both cars in at the same charger here, the 300 kilowatt charger, and we can see both at the same time. Ooh, you, is this you? Yeah, you get 112 kilowatt, I get 88 kilowatt, but he's at a lower state of charge. We didn't preheat the batteries on the way here. We preheated to the supercharger, and of course while it was charging. Still 96 kilowatt on the all-wheel drive and 81 on the rear-wheel drive. Very interesting. I plugged in first, that's why it's 18 minutes. He a minute later, 17 minutes, but he's higher state of charge than I am. And we saw up here, you can see the kilowatt hours charged. He charged so far 25.3, 23.3, so 2 kilowatt hours more. Let's analyze this data. Like I said in the video, both had 19 inch winter tires on, same dimensions but different rims, both have a heat pump. All wheel drive arrived with 43%, rear wheel drive with 47%, so 37% used by the all wheel drive, 33% used by the rear wheel drive. Average consumption 197 watt hours per kilometer on the all wheel drive, 184 on the rear wheel drive, that's 7% more. When I calculate the range, I get to 351 kilometers on the all-wheel drive and 393 kilometers on the rear-wheel drive, and I get 12% more range in the rear-wheel drive. Now, why is it 12 and not 7? Can be a few reasons. Maybe Tesla has increased the battery of the Model Y, I don't know. And there could also be degradation on the all-wheel drive because he has the car for 2 years and drove, I don't even know how far, but the rear wheel drive is practically new with 5,000 kilometers. So who knows? Then charging. The all wheel drive charged 29.9 kilowatt hours, the rear wheel drive 28.175 kilowatt hours. That's 6.15% more. So this is more in line with the more average consumption. And the all-wheel drive took 23 minutes, the rear-wheel drive 24 minutes for whatever reason, and that's an average charging power of 78 kilowatt on the all-wheel drive, but only 70 kilowatt on the rear-wheel drive. I don't know why. And then when we take the average consumption, including charging loss, so what you have to pay at the charging station, we get to 230 watt-hours per kilometer on the all-wheel drive and 216 on the rear-wheel drive. This again is 6.5%. So again, very close, 7%, 6.15 and 650. So the it looks like it was a good result that we had here. So if this 6% is all the rims, I don't think so. I'm guessing the rims make maybe a percent, maybe two. I don't know. I don't know if there have been tests with the new Model Y against rims against the old Model Y rims without the efficiency thing there, the better aerodynamic thing that you can take off. No idea. But I've seen in other SUVs, comparing them from rear-wheel drive to all-wheel drive, that it was around 7%, so that looks good. And the reason is, again, the front motor, if you drive constant, doesn't do anything, but it still has to turn, so there's no power directed. But since it's turning, there's loss, and the loss is a few percent. That's why rear-wheel drive usually have lower consumption than all-wheel drive. Only Polestar 3 can disconnect the motor completely, and then you really don't have any loss. But that was the result, and I think it's pretty good. 6.5%, it's totally okay, and the range looks great, and also good charging. Amazing. If you want to follow me on Instagram, BatteryLife1, and if you want to support the channel, there's a Patreon link in the description below, and here on YouTube there's also a channel membership. And if you want to know what's happening behind the scenes, I have a third YouTube channel, Behind the Battery. But that's it for me. Thank you very much for watching. Have a great day and take care. Bye.